ਗੁੱਡ ਮਾਰਨਿੰਗ ਬ੍ਰੈਕਫਾਸਟ ਬਾਅਦ 'ਚ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਸਵਾਗਤ ਹੈ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਕੋਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਹਰ ਵੀਕ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਕਿਸੇ ਨਾ ਕਿਸੇ ਮੁੱਦੇ ਦੇ ਬਾਰੇ 'ਚ ਦੱਸੀਏ ਔਰ ਆਪਣੇ ਇੱਥੇ ਸਾਊਥ ਏਸ਼ੀਅਨ ਭਾਈਚਾਰੇ ਨੂੰ ਇਹ ਦੱਸੀਏ ਕਿ ਆਪਾਂ ਮੇਨ ਸਟ੍ਰੀਮ ਕੈਨੇਡੀਅਨਸ ਨਾਲ ਮਿਲ ਕੇ ਰਹਿਣਾ ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਅ ਨਿਊ ਕੰਟਰੀ ਵੀ ਹੈਵ ਟੂ ਅੰਡਰਸਟੈਂਡ ਇਟ ਇਸ ਚੀਜ਼ ਨੂੰ ਅੱਗੇ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਚੱਲਦੇ ਹੋਏ ਅਸੀਂ ਦੱਸਣਾ ਚਾਹਾਂਗੇ ਕਿ ਰਮਜ਼ਾਨ ਦਾ ਮਹੀਨਾ ਸ਼ੁਰੂ ਹੋਣ ਵਾਲਾ ਹੈ 2 ਅਗਸਤ ਤੋਂ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਆਮ ਜ਼ਬਾਨ 'ਚ ਰੋਜ਼ਿਆਂ ਦਾ ਮਹੀਨਾ ਕਿਹਾ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਹੈ ਮੁਸਲਮਾਨ ਭੈਣ ਭਰਾਵਾਂ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਇੱਕ ਚੀਜ਼ ਹਰ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ ਦਾ ਟੈਲੀਵਿਜ਼ਨ ਸਟੇਸ਼ਨ ਦੱਸਣ ਡਿਆ ਕਿ ਇਸ ਸੀਜ਼ਨ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਚੀਜ਼ਾਂ ਜਿਹੜੀਆਂ ਨੇ ਲੋਕ ਆ ਕੇ ਦੱਸਣ ਡਏ ਨੇ ਕਿ 100% ਤੱਕ ਮਹਿੰਗੀਆਂ ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦੀਆਂ 70% ਮਹਿੰਗੀਆਂ ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦੀਆਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਜਦੋਂ ਕਿ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ ਨੂੰ ਇੱਥੇ ਆ ਕੇ ਦੇਖਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਕਿ ਇੱਥੇ ਜਦੋਂ ਵੀ ਕੋਈ ਮੇਨ ਸਟ੍ਰੀਮ ਇਵੈਂਟ ਆਉਂਦਾ ਕੈਨੇਡਾ 'ਚ ਯੂਰਪ 'ਚ ਯੂਨਾਈਟਿਡ ਸਟੇਟਸ 'ਚ ਅਤੇ ਚੀਜ਼ਾਂ ਕ੍ਰਿਸਮਿਸ ਦੇ ਟਾਈਮ ਨਿਊ ਈਅਰ ਦੇ ਟਾਈਮ ਸਸਤੀਆਂ ਹੁੰਦੀਆਂ ਨੇ 70% ਔਫ ਹੁੰਦੀਆਂ ਨੇ ਤਾਂ ਕਿ ਇੱਕ ਆਮ ਗਰੀਬ ਇਨਸਾਨ ਵੀ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਖਰੀਦ ਸਕੇ ਇਹ ਮੈਸੇਜ ਅਸੀਂ ਦੇਣਾ ਚਾਹਾਂਗੇ ਆਪਣੀ ਸੁਸਾਇਟੀ ਨੂੰ ਬੈਕ ਹੋਮ ਕਿ ਅਸੀਂ ਇੱਥੇ ਆ ਕੇ ਇਹ ਸਿੱਖਿਆ ਲਈ ਔਰ ਇਹ ਇੱਕ ਅੱਛੀ ਚੀਜ਼ ਹੈ ਇਹਨੂੰ ਉੱਥੇ ਵੀ ਲਾਗੂ ਹੋਣਾ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਕਿ ਇੰਨੇ ਪਵਿੱਤਰ ਮਹੀਨੇ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਅਸੀਂ ਇੱਕ ਦੂਜੇ ਨੂੰ ਲੁੱਟਣ ਦੇ ਉੱਤੇ ਤੁਰੇ ਹੋਏ ਹਾਂ ਨਾ ਕਿ ਇੱਕ ਦੂਜੇ ਦੀ ਹੈਲਪ ਕਰਨ 'ਚ ਉਹਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਨਾਲ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਅੱਜ ਦੇ ਪ੍ਰੋਗਰਾਮ ਦੇ ਬਾਰੇ 'ਚ ਦੱਸਾਂਗੇ ਹਮੇਸ਼ਾ ਦੀ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਪ੍ਰੋਗਰਾਮ ਰੱਬ ਦੇ ਨਾਂ ਤੋਂ ਸ਼ੁਰੂ ਕਰਾਂਗੇ ਅੱਗੇ ਚੱਲ ਕੇ ਬ੍ਰੈਡ ਬਟ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਮਿਸਿਸਾਗਾ ਸਟ੍ਰੀਟਸਵਿਲ ਦੇ MP ਨੇ ਨਿਊਲੀ ਇਲੈਕਟਿਡ MP ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦਾ ਇੰਟਰਵਿਊ ਦਿਖਾਵਾਂਗੇ ਇਹਦੇ ਬਾਅਦ ਪ੍ਰੋਵਿੰਸ਼ਲ ਇਲੈਕਸ਼ਨ ਹੋਣ 'ਚ ਆ ਰਿਹਾ ਪ੍ਰੋਵਿੰਸ਼ਲ ਚੋਣਾਂ ਦੇ ਬਾਰੇ 'ਚ PC ਦੇ ਕੈਂਡੀਡੇਟ ਨੇ ਪੈਮ ਹੁੰਡਲ ਜੀ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਫਿਸ ਦੀ ਓਪਨਿੰਗ ਕੀਤੀ ਕੰਪੇਨ ਆਫਿਸ ਦੀ ਉਹਦੀ ਕੁਝ ਝਲਕੀਆਂ ਦਿਖਾਵਾਂਗੇ ਇਸੇ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਚੋਣਾਂ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਨਾਲ ਚੱਲਦੇ ਹੋਏ ਅਸੀਂ ਚੱਲਾਂਗੇ ਲਿਬਰਲ ਪਾਰਟੀ ਵੱਲ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਇੱਕ MPP ਨੇ ਆਪਣਾ ਐਨੂਅਲ ਬਾਰਬਕਿਊ ਰੱਖਿਆ ਵਿਕ ਢਿੱਲੋਂ ਨੇ ਉਹ ਦਿਖਾਵਾਂਗੇ ਇੰਸ਼ੋਰੈਂਸ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਆਟੋਮੋਬਾਈਲ ਇੰਸ਼ੋਰੈਂਸ ਇੰਟੀਰੀਅਰ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਸਕਾਈ ਹਾਈ ਹੋ ਗਈ ਹੈ ਕੁਛ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਦੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਵਿਚਾਰ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਦਿਖਾਵਾਂਗੇ ਉਹਦੇ ਬਾਰੇ 'ਚ ਆਈ ਹੋਪ ਯੂ ਲਾਈਕ ਦ ਪ੍ਰੋਗਰਾਮ ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ ਐਂਡ ਗੋਡ ਬਲੈਸ ਯੂ
जब लड़की अपनी स्किन की वजह से परेशान हो
तो फिकर की क्या बात है लेजर स्पॉट है ना
लेजर स्पॉट फोटो फेशियल थर्माज एंटीएजिंग लेजर हेयर रिमूवल लेजर स्पॉट वेयर ब्यूटी मीट्स एलिगेंट प्रोफेशनल्स
लेजर स्पॉट हाईवे 10 और क्वींस के संगम पर कॉल शैला 9054872680
ਜਦੋਂ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਐਕਸੀਡੈਂਟ ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਹੈ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਪਾਸ ਕਈ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਦੇ ਸਵਾਲ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਹਨ
ਕਦੇ ਵੀ ਆਪਣਾ ਕਲੇਮ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ ਸੈਟਲ ਕਰਨ ਦੀ ਕੋਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਨਾ ਕਰੋ
ਆਪਣੇ ਹੱਕਾਂ ਲਈ ਇੱਕ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਤਜਰਬੇਕਾਰ ਪਰਸਨਲ ਇੰਜਰੀ ਲਾਇਰ ਰਮੇਸ਼ ਸੰਗਾ ਨੂੰ ਮਿਲੋ
ਤੁਰੰਤ ਸਾਡੀਆਂ ਸੇਵਾਵਾਂ ਲਈ ਆਓ ਤੇ ਵਧੀਆ ਤੋਂ ਵਧੀਆ ਮੁਆਵਜ਼ਾ ਲਓ
ਹਮ ਰੀਅਲ ਸਟੇਟ ਫੈਮਿਲੀ ਲਾਅ ਔਰ ਇਮੀਗ੍ਰੇਸ਼ਨ ਮੇਂ ਵੀ ਸਰਵਿਸਿਜ਼ ਦੇਤੇ ਹੈ
905-670-9911
अपने कारोबार की तरक्की के लिए प्रिंट पब्लिसिटी और बेहतरीन प्रिंटिंग के लिए सिर्फ एक ही नाम
साइंस टू गो
जहां जदीद टेक्नोलॉजी से स्टोर फ्रंट साइंस चैनल लेटर्स बैनर्स रियल स्टेट साइंस सैंडविच बोर्ड्स व्हीकल ग्राफिक्स बिजनेस कार्ड्स पोस्ट कार्ड्स लेबल्स फ्लायर्स आपके बजट और आपके वक्त में बनाए जाते हैं आपका काम सिर्फ सोचना है क्योंकि
वी प्रिंट योर थॉट्स
साइंस टू गो
दिन को रात और रात को दिन बना रहा है, वही खुदा है, वही खुदा है, वही खुदा है, वही खुदा है। कोई तो है जो निजाम हस्ती चला
लड़की अपनी स्किन की वजह से परेशान हो
तो फिकर की क्या बात है, लेजर स्पॉट है ना।
लेजर स्पॉट, फोटो फेशियल, थर्माज, एंटी एजिंग, लेजर हेयर रिमूवल, लेजर स्पॉट, वेयर ब्यूटी मीट्स एलिगेंट प्रोफेशनल्स।
लेजर स्पॉट, हाईवे 10 और क्वींस के संगम पर। कॉल शैला 905-487-2680।
ਜਦੋਂ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਐਕਸੀਡੈਂਟ ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਹੈ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਪਾਸ ਕਈ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਦੇ ਸਵਾਲ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਹਨ।
ਕਦੇ ਵੀ ਆਪਣਾ ਕਲੇਮ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ ਸੈਟਲ ਕਰਨ ਦੀ ਕੋਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਨਾ ਕਰੋ।
ਆਪਣੇ ਹੱਕਾਂ ਲਈ ਇੱਕ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਤਜਰਬੇਕਾਰ ਪਰਸਨਲ ਇੰਜਰੀ ਲਾਇਰ ਰਮੇਸ਼ ਸੰਗਾ ਨੂੰ ਮਿਲੋ।
ਤੁਰੰਤ ਸਾਡੀਆਂ ਸੇਵਾਵਾਂ ਲਿਆਓ ਤੇ ਵਧੀਆ ਤੋਂ ਵਧੀਆ ਮੁਆਵਜ਼ਾ ਲਓ।
ਹਮ ਰੀਅਲ ਸਟੇਟ, ਫੈਮਿਲੀ ਲਾਅ ਔਰ ਇਮੀਗ੍ਰੇਸ਼ਨ ਮੇਂ ਵੀ ਸਰਵਿਸਿਜ਼ ਦੇਤੇ ਹੈਂ।
905-670-9911।
अपने कारोबार की तरक्की के लिए प्रिंट पब्लिसिटी और बेहतरीन प्रिंटिंग के लिए सिर्फ एक ही नाम,
साइंस टू गो।
जहां जदीद टेक्नोलॉजी से स्टोर फ्रंट साइंस, चैनल लेटर्स, बैनर्स, रियल स्टेट साइंस, सैंडविच बोर्ड्स, व्हीकल ग्राफिक्स, बिजनेस कार्ड्स, पोस्ट कार्ड्स, लेबल्स, फ्लायर्स आपके बजट और आपके वक्त में बनाए जाते हैं। आपका काम सिर्फ सोचना है, क्योंकि
प्रिंट योर थॉट्स।
साइंस टू गो।
Morning, welcome to Breakfast Buzz, where we do make a point every week to bring out issue-based discussions and at the same time trying to make new Canadians and youth aware of our political social system, educate them so they could very much be involved in the day-to-day system and be prepared to ask questions to their leaders. Today we have newly elected Member of Parliament Mr. Brad Butt, who happens to be from the riding of Mississauga Streetsville, obviously in Mississauga. We welcome you to our show, sir.
Thank you very much for the invitation.
My pleasure, sir. Let's begin with the congratulation part for a majority government, finally.
Thank you.
At least we know this government is going to be there for 4 years, and we wouldn't have a unwanted election every now and then, because federal elections were becoming a joke before that. That's an honest opinion.
Yeah.
At least we have something that we look forward to. The people have spoken. We respect the mandate the people have given you. Congratulations to you for being in the parliament to begin with. You tell me, who is Brad Butt?
Well, thank you for the congratulations, and I guess I can certainly tell you that when I was out knocking on doors, that the constituents in my riding made it clear they wanted stability in their national government. And I think they got what they wanted. They wanted a national majority government. They wanted us to get on with the job at hand and focus on the priority issues like the jobs and the economy, which is job number one for our government. My background is I've been an active volunteer in the city of Mississauga for close to 30 years. I've worked with a number of different organizations during that time, and I think I've learned a lot about my city and my country. And so when there was an opportunity to place my name forward earlier this year to be the Conservative Party candidate in the riding, I did so knowing that after living in the city my whole life and learning lots about it, that I felt I could be a very strong representative for the community in the House of Commons. My professional background, I ran an organization called the Greater Toronto Apartment Association, which is an organization for Toronto-based owners of rental apartment buildings. And in that professional background, because I come from the property management background professionally, I've had the opportunity to work with all three levels of government, to work with many groups of people with diverse views on housing-related issues. And again, I think it's made me work very hard to listen to people and try and bring diverse opinions together and come up with the best overall decision at the end of the day that benefits the community. So I hope that background will work well for me. I'm married. I have two daughters, 11 and 7. And as I say, I've been a lifelong resident of the city of Mississauga.
So that's who Brad Butt is to begin with. Now, what does Brad Butt, as a newly elected MP of the federal parliament, bring out to the people of Mississauga? Reason why I ask you this is you have a very diverse community living in your riding, and which is the beauty of Canada. Yep. And Ontario to begin with, GT in general. What message or accomplishments do you intend to bring on in the forthcoming years? What can people look up to? That's the exact.
Well, the most important thing is that I'm very approachable. I want everybody to know. I just left before coming for this interview with meetings in my constituency office. People call.
Cut you off here, reason being you are very accessible. Even we fixed up this interview through a social network.
Through Facebook,
site.
We did.
And you.
We've been communicating through Facebook.
You promptly returned.
Well, you know what?
I can adhere.
Because I'll tell you what I learned. I learned through 20 years of working in the service industry in the private sector, property management. We are caring for people's homes. That you have to respond to people. You have to get back to people. You have to try and solve problems where you can. That's my professional background. I don't know any different. So to me, it doesn't matter what your background is. It doesn't matter how your family's made up. It doesn't matter what part of the riding you live in. If I can help, if my office can help, we're going to do that. Now, are we going to be able to solve every problem? No. Are we going to be able to make everybody happy? Probably not. But we're going to do our very best. And that's just because that's what my parents instilled in me. That's what I've learned through working in the private sector. And for so many community organizations is we're all in this together. I think we all want the same thing for our families. We want safe neighborhoods. We want good jobs. And we want to know that our children are going to have done better than we did. That's every culture, every background, every group of people I talk to all want the same. They want strong families and strong neighborhoods and good jobs so that they can do well and that their children can do better than they have done. And whether you're like me and you're fourth generation Canadian living in this country or you're a brand new resident or citizen of this country, we all want the same thing. And that's the kind of member of parliament that I want to be and that I hope that I will be over the next 4 years.
Like you very well said, and we were talking off camera also, that we live for our kids, for a better future for them.
That's why I ran.
Yes, that's what we are all about. And being a family person, that is my prime motive also, coming out of the house every day. Is there a better future for my daughter, and what would make it happen in a more worthwhile manner?
Absolutely.
And coming back to this, how do you handle, I know it is very hard, and you very well said you can't please everybody, but the main thing is a member of parliament or a community leader or a leader of a house, he or she is accessible. At least people can walk up to you and ask questions. It could be solved, not solved. You're not Santa Claus. Nobody's claiming here we are. Yeah. But communication, the lines of communications are open, and that makes it a bit easier at least to express oneself.
Right.
Having said that, your riding, as already said, is very diverse. And sometimes the issues don't match to somebody or some group's cultural backgrounds. I mean, it doesn't make them bad, it doesn't make them good. But sometimes you see there are food issues, there are prayer issues, there are cultural issues.
Mm-hmm.
How would you intend to bridge that gap? Because Reason being, there was a fear before the election and a very widely circulated propaganda. I would call it propaganda because no proof of that still, that conservatives are not very immigrant friendly.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And I heard that.
Yes. I think all over the press.
Yeah, I think it's an unfair criticism. I think it was in many respects, and I don't want to get too partisan on this show today. We've just been through that in an election campaign. But, you know, I think the Liberals, in a desperate attempt towards the end, because I think they saw what was happening in the election, tried to stir up some of the fears again. I mean, look at the work Jason Kenney has done over the past couple of years that he's been the Minister of Immigration, Citizenship, and Multiculturalism. And, you know, and I say that, I hope, in the most nonpartisan spirit. This has been the most engaged, the most active, the most involved minister of that portfolio I have ever seen maybe in my lifetime. He has taken a very strong outreach approach to his role, which, you know what, he doesn't necessarily have to act that way. It's the way Jason is. And what he's done is, what the Minister of Immigration has done is, he's instilled in all of us as local MPs that we have that responsibility. I see my role two ways. I'm an advocate and I'm an ombudsman. And what I mean by that is, when I see things that are going on that should be changed in our own government, as well as in other areas, I need to be an advocate for responsible change. Also, my role is to be that ombudsman, someone coming into my office who's having difficulty working through government, whether it be an immigration file, whether it be a tax issue, whether it be a pension issue. The member of parliament is there to be your ombudsman, to take on that fight, sometimes with the bureaucrats, to get a better answer or a better situation resolved over what the problem is. That's for all residents of our community. So, you know, when we had labels like we're anti-immigrant or we're not interested in multiculturalism or in promoting good relations among all Canadians, I think those are very unfair comments about our party. We have an extremely diverse caucus. People from all backgrounds, some of the newly elected MPs, many of them are immigrants to Canada. They were not born. They were not born in Canada, and they're members of Parliament today. I think of my good friend Vladislav Leetson, who's the member of Parliament for Mississauga East Cooksville, who worked in the mines in Poland and immigrated to this country in his early 20s. Wanted to get out of communist Poland. He's a member of Parliament today. He's a shining example of what Canada's all about. That you can immigrate to this country, you can work hard, and you can become a member of parliament or whatever it is that you want to do in this country. That's the great thing about Canada. So I think our party and our government has worked very hard to listen to and respond to concerns that different communities have made to us. And we've had fabulous leadership in Minister Kenney.
Absolutely. He's very accessible as well. I've had talks with him over many issues. And definitely he mixes up very well in all ethnic communities, I could say that very safely. Having said that, what is your plan? Let's particularly focus on your riding now, since you are there, you are in office. What are your plans to make the people of your riding feel that they'll have a better life in 4 years to come?
Well, the key thing again is concentrating on jobs and the economy, because a strong economy lifts everything else up, right? If we have good jobs in our neighborhood, if people can live and work in Mississauga, that's better for the environment because there's less commuting. It's better for families because there's more family time together. That's my interest, and I'm going to be reaching out. I've done some already, and I will keep doing it. I am going to be talking to people in the business community in my riding and saying, what are your challenges? What do we need to do as a country to make it easier for you to do business and keep the employees you have now and hopefully hire a whole bunch more who are going to hopefully be residents of my community that are going to get good jobs and be able to be active participants in the community. So my focus as a local member of parliament is going to be on continued economic growth and prosperity, working with communities, working with business leaders and others to make sure we get that done. Second, I guess, priority for me is generally making sure that government works well for people but isn't constantly in your face. I think people feel they are over-governed, They are overregulated. I think they want to enjoy their lives and their communities and their families without having a lot of government in their face. So
maintain the space.
And absolutely. And I think, you know, many people who've come to this country have come from countries where they were extremely oppressed, extremely abused. Yes. Where minority rights were not respected in those, and they've come to Canada for peace and freedom, and that's why they're here. The last thing they want is the heavy hand of government clubbing them over the head every day through high taxes, through high regulation. When I went door-to-door talking to people, they made it very clear. They like the way we operate as a government, which is we keep finding ways to cut taxes, we keep finding ways to invest in families as a major priority, and we philosophically believe as a government that less government is better government. And I think the voters have agreed with that.
One pressing and burning question that I ask almost everybody, especially who happens to be elected from the general GTA area. According to Stats Canada, the most visibly known minority are the South Asians in GTA.
Right.
But when it comes to jobs, government jobs. Let's start with government jobs. And you are just hardly in office, so I'm not blaming you for anything.
Yeah, yeah.
We think the South Asians, and I'm talking from a minority point of view, and I speak for all minorities, not only South Asians, mm-hmm. mind you, but mm-hmm. since we are in majority here, we are not being fairly treated. Look at the ratio into any government office. Let it be municipal, let it be federal, let it be provincial. Mm-hmm. How do you plan to address that? Because at grassroots levels, again, it's no single person's fault, and I'm not blaming mm-hmm. anybody. Mm-hmm. It has to be addressed. People do feel frustrated.
Yeah, one of the difficulties at the federal level of government is that many of the jobs require you to be bilingual. So if you do not speak French, it is going to mean that, and if you certainly have come from a country where French is not a language that has been spoken, which will be the case with most from the South Asian community, is that it does make federal civil service jobs more difficult for people that don't have a strong command of both English and French. Now, not all jobs are bilingual, but there is no doubt that because of the nature of Canada being a country of two official languages, that many of the job prospects do require you to be able to speak and communicate orally and written in English and in French. So that is a disadvantage for sure for people who have come from communities and parts of the world where French is not a language that has been used. So that's one of the difficulties. The second difficulty is that obviously what we're using as the main criteria is experience and obviously credentials, whether it be degrees or whatever, for specific jobs that would require that. We've got some work to do, no doubt, not just in government jobs, but as we know in private sector jobs where international credentials are not recognized, which means that we have people who have been trained as doctors or engineers or whatever it is are not able to practice that in Canada because the credentials aren't recognized. We have some difficulties around that in the federal civil service as well. I won't deny that. We've got some challenges there. Do we need to relook at how the Public Service of Canada is structured, how people are applying and getting jobs, the bilingualism issue, although I don't want to get into an English-French thing because that's not where we're going.
Issue.
We may have to relook at how we're doing hiring. That would certainly be through the President of the Treasury Board, so through Minister Clement's area would be looking at that, and certainly through the how we interact with the Public Service Alliance of Canada, which represents most of the federal workers across the country. But there's no doubt we've got work to do there. And I can understand the South Asian community feeling that they're underrepresented in the federal civil service. I'm sure they feel the same way at the provincial and municipal level as well. And we just got to keep working on it.
But one very friendly suggestion that we want you to carry, if you could, is that if French is the issue, which is a very valid point, I agree to that. Shouldn't there be federally sponsored or funded programs that immigrants, especially in the South Asian region, be allowed or be welcome to learn French?
Well, you know what? I'm going to take that back because it's a very good point. I think we've spent a lot of our time focusing on ESL-related stuff, making sure that new Canadians can have a strong command of English. But we may not have done as good a job in making sure that they also have a good command, if they so choose, of French. So maybe
which is equally important.
You're right. So maybe we need to rejig some of those programs. I mean, I think that's something I will make a note of that. I will raise it with the government, because maybe when we're looking at these programs we're already offering to integrate new Canadians and pushing the English side, maybe we should have a stream in there where we are encouraging those individuals to also take French as well as English.
Absolutely, because our program and my personal theme always has been to bridge the gap amongst communities.
Yeah.
That's what
Canada
is all about.
I think we want to make it. We have to do what we can to make it as easy as possible for new Canadians to be employed in Canada, whether it's the public service or the private sector. And if there's things that we need to do, if there's ways we need to change those programs, I'm serving on the Human Resources and Skills Development Committee in Ottawa. I mean, we've only had preliminary meetings in June, but we're going to get down to the meat of some of these programs in the fall when we're back as a committee. And I'm going to make a note of that, and that might be something that we need to look at, that we need to put some more focus on encouraging people to get French competency as well as English.
Sir,
so we've done something today that's positive.
Yes,
that's accomplished.
That's what the
that's
whole
good.
Thing is. That's what the
that's
whole
good
point
stuff.
Is.
Yep.
Before we end it for the day, I would want you to give some message out to the viewers, whatever you so desire. Before thanking you, I would want you to do that.
Well, thank you very much for the opportunity to come in. I know it was a little bit longer than we had thought it would be, because we thought we were going to do this shortly after the election, and it didn't work out, but it's a pleasure to be here. I look forward to coming back again. I guess the message I have is that if you do live in the Mississauga Streetsville riding, to let you know our office is open. We're at 154 Queen Street South, right in the heart of the old village of Streetsville. Our office is open every day, and I have excellent staff in there that are willing to work with you and help out if you have any issues. You can always set up an appointment if you so choose to meet with me as well. That's the kind of Member of Parliament that I am and that I want to be for you. And I just want to thank the voters once again for their tremendous confidence. I was overwhelmed with the result on election night. It's a very strong mandate. We take it very seriously. And we're going to work very hard for you for the next 4 years. Thank you again for the opportunity, and thank you for your confidence.
So, ladies and gentlemen, this was Mr. Brad Butt, the newly elected Member of Parliament for Mississauga Streetsville. I must say, it's not to please him. Easygoing, fun-loving, a straight talker. And that's what we like from politicians whom you can communicate with. We'll have his website, his email on the screen. Feel free to get in touch with him. Any questions or concerns, email us. If we could forward him, we'll bring him on a live show also whenever we so can. Timing is the main issue. God bless you. Do have a nice day.
जब लड़की अपनी स्किन की वजह से परेशान हो
तो फिकर की क्या बात है लेजर स्पॉट है ना
लेजर स्पॉट फोटो फेशियल थर्माज एंटी एजिंग लेजर हेयर रिमूवल लेजर स्पॉट वेयर ब्यूटी मीट्स एलिगेंट प्रोफेशनल्स
लेजर स्पॉट हाईवे 10 और क्वींस के संगम पर कॉल शैला 905-487-2680
ਜਦੋਂ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਐਕਸੀਡੈਂਟ ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਹੈ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਪਾਸ ਕਈ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਦੇ ਸਵਾਲ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਹਨ
ਕਦੇ ਵੀ ਆਪਣਾ ਕਲੇਮ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ ਸੈਟਲ ਕਰਨ ਦੀ ਕੋਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਨਾ ਕਰੋ
ਆਪਣੇ ਹੱਕਾਂ ਲਈ ਇੱਕ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਤਜਰਬੇਕਾਰ ਪਰਸਨਲ ਇੰਜਰੀ ਲਾਇਰ ਰਮੇਸ਼ ਸੰਗਾ ਨੂੰ ਮਿਲੋ
ਤੁਰੰਤ ਸਾਡੀਆਂ ਸੇਵਾਵਾਂ ਲਿਆਓ ਤੇ ਵਧੀਆ ਤੋਂ ਵਧੀਆ ਮੁਆਵਜ਼ਾ ਲਾਓ
ਹਮ ਰੀਅਲ ਸਟੇਟ ਫੈਮਿਲੀ ਲਾਅ ਔਰ ਇਮੀਗ੍ਰੇਸ਼ਨ ਮੇਂ ਵੀ ਸਰਵਿਸਿਜ਼ ਦੇਤੇ ਹੈ 905-670-9911
अपने कारोबार की तरक्की के लिए प्रिंट पब्लिसिटी और बेहतरीन प्रिंटिंग के लिए सिर्फ एक ही नाम
साइंस टू गो
जहां जदीद टेक्नोलॉजी से स्टोर फ्रंट साइंस चैनल लेटर्स बैनर्स रियल स्टेट साइंस सैंडविच बोर्ड्स व्हीकल ग्राफिक्स बिजनेस कार्ड्स पोस्ट कार्ड्स लेबल्स फ्लायर्स आपके बजट और आपके वक्त पे बनाए जाते हैं आपका काम सिर्फ सोचना है क्योंकि
वी प्रिंट योर थॉट्स
साइंस टू गो
Thank you, Ron. Good afternoon, everyone. Ron is actually such a nice guy. I didn't even have to tell him to say so many wonderful things about me, but you did anyways. Thank you. Thank you, Ron. It's always amazing and it's always wonderful to be among so many conservatives, especially right here in the region of Peel and in Brampton, Springdale. We're all here to support Pam Hundal. Pam is an amazing individual. She is a great candidate. You know, I've, as most of you may know, I've been a candidate for a long time before getting elected on May the 2nd. And I can tell you, it is not easy to put your name forward, regardless what party you may represent. So I salute every individual, every candidate that puts their name forward, and especially Pam, because Pam, as you know, being in Brampton, especially being a woman with a young family, very young children, and to dedicate the kind of time that she does, it is truly unbelievable. You know, she ran in the last election, came close. Like myself, she did not give up. We both kept on encouraging one another. She was an amazing asset to our campaign in the federal election. And I am looking forward to working along with my entire team and making sure that we get Pam elected on October the 6th. So I would like to request all of you and encourage all of you to please reach out to your family, reach out to your friends, reach out to your neighbors. Get them involved, pass the word along. In the region of Peel, we do not have it easy. We have to earn it. We have to work hard. So every little effort is going to make a difference, especially the youth. Pam has been very big on youth and especially getting the women involved on the campaign. So I'd like to salute and thank the entire youth that has been helping campaign door knock in this summer and hot holidays. You know, I follow Pam on Twitter and Facebook, and she's an incredible candidate, and she's got an amazing amount of energy, and we got to make sure that we get her elected on October the 6th as the member of the provincial parliament right here in Brampton Springdale, along with and under the leadership of our next and great Premier Tim Hudak. It's always very nice to have you in Brampton, Tim, and really looking forward to many, many of your visits as the next Premier of Ontario. Thank you so much. Enjoy the rest of the day. Thank you.
And I would like to request to Honorable Bill Davis if he can introduce the Pam after.
Yes, a pleasure to be here, particularly Senator Fonzie. But before I introduce Pam, I have to make an announcement, because her parents, who are responsible for her being here, in fact, responsible for her being alive, they celebrated their 50th wedding anniversary about a month ago. Now, the only thing I can observe, I can't quite understand why Pam's mother looks so much younger than Sam. Sam, will you forgive me? Yeah, see, there he is. He's waving his hand, and Pam, he's in total agreement. I always get nervous when Senator Contadino's on any platform. He's liable to promise anything to anyone, and now he's promised that Pam will win. I think we can all go home. It's a great Tory. I want to introduce a lady who has not been introduced. Her name is Kay Weatherall, and she was president of the party while I was Premier, one of the great ladies historically for the Progressive Conservative Party of Ontario. Kay, stand up and say hello. I've only lived in Brampton for nearly 82 years, and it's great to see a candidate like Pam represent now this part of Brampton. So Pam, it's a pleasure to introduce to you. I mean, Con spoke a long time, others did. I don't want you to thank me as the guest speaker. The guest speaker is after you, our leader. So ladies and gentlemen, a pleasure to introduce our candidate, our next member, Pam Hundal.
Thank you, everyone, for being here today. I am so humbled when I look around the room and I see all of you. You've taken your time out on a busy Saturday to come here once again and show your support for me, as you have been doing over the past year. I was nominated a little over a year ago, and from that time I made the commitment to be active in the community, work hard, and be a voice for the people of Brampton Springdale. And I think we've done a pretty good job of doing that, would you say? Yeah. I want to begin by just thanking the team that put this event together today. If you look around the room, we have so many youth. These are young people that could be sleeping on a Saturday morning, but they choose to roll out of bed and come and door knock with me, or help blow up balloons, or come make this event a success. So I really want to thank, this is the future of Brampton. These are young people that go to high school and university. They deserve a real applause here. I also want to acknowledge once again, and we can't acknowledge them enough, the women who come out, who take time from their families to spend time in my campaign. I know it was mentioned today that we have a Muslim Pakistani group of women. They rarely come, if ever, to political events. They've decided to support me. I've met with them. I'm so honored to have their support and all of the support of women in this room today. I also want to acknowledge my colleagues, my fellow candidates, Sanjeev Mangi, Ben Shinuda, for all of the hard work they've been doing. They're excellent candidates. We're all working hard together. Thank you so much for being here. We have counselors here. Gail Miles, you're a wonderful counselor. Thank you so much. I think we ran into Sandra Haynes at the farmer's market. She might be here. And so thank you for our counselors being here today. I want to thank, my campaign manager, Ron Jutta. You know, he's up here. He's speaking. Yeah. You know, Ron... Ron is a true example of what a dedicated volunteer. He's a young man, he has a young family, he's starting his career off, but he's made the commitment to my campaign until October 6th. He's available day and night. Anytime he meets someone, he's available to them, he's available to us. You know, he is a wonderful gentleman, and I'm so honored that he's my campaign manager, and I want to thank you, Ron, for all of your hard work and dedication.
Here today, I want to say that I am apt of the quality of Pam Hundal running for us in Brampton Springdale. A successful lawyer, a young mom dedicated to her community on the Environmental Committee, Children's Aid, and somebody that's working hard and will make a difference not only for Brampton but for the province of Ontario as our next MPP. I want to thank our special guests as well, particularly Premier Davis. And under Premier Davis, Ontario was a leader in Canada. Yeah. We were number one in this country. Yeah. And this is the longest serving premier in the 20th century, and somebody I want to thank for his outstanding leadership and his personal advice and support, and somebody who put Brampton on the map for all of North America. Premier, thank you very much. Law-abiding citizens who pay higher auto insurance premiums as a result. I think that's wrong. And Dalton McGuinty is looking the other way.
with Pam Hundal as part of the PC majority government, we'll shut down those scams, we'll put those who are breaking the rules behind bars, and pass on the savings to people who play by the rules through their auto insurance premiums.
Mere vallo saryan nu sat sri akal. Aaj meri campaign office di opening se si, nala campaign di kick-off. Aaj bohut sare jaane saadi community to aaya. Main saryan nu dhanwad karna jehde tusi apna keemti time kadke itthe aaye sige. ਮੈਂ ਸਾਰੀ ਸਾਡੀ ਕੋਰ ਟੀਮ ਨੂੰ ਅਸੀਂ ਬਹੁਤ ਅਪਰੀਸ਼ੀਏਟ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਅੱਜ ਸਾਡਾ ਪੀ ਸੀ ਲੀਡਰ ਟਿਮ ਹੁਡਾਕ ਵੀ ਆਏ ਸੀਗੇ ਐਮ ਪੀ ਫਾਰਮ ਗਿੱਲ ਐਂਡ ਫਾਰਮਰ ਪ੍ਰੀਮੀਅਰ ਬਿਲ ਡੇਵਿਸ ਸੋ ਵੀ ਜਸਟ ਵਾਂਟ ਟੂ ਥੈਂਕ ਐਵਰੀ ਵਨ ਫਾਰ ਯੋਰ ਸਪੋਰਟ ਐਂਡ ਵੀ ਲੁੱਕ ਫੋਰਵਰਡ ਟੂ ਯੋਰ ਸਪੋਰਟ ਫਾਰ ਅਕਟੋਬਰ 6th ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ ਵੈਰੀ ਮੱਚ
ਜਬ ਲੜਕੀ ਆਪਣੀ ਸਕਿਨ ਕੀ ਵਜ੍ਹਾ ਸੇ ਪਰੇਸ਼ਾਨ ਹੋ
ਤੋ ਫਿਕਰ ਕੀ ਕਿਆ ਬਾਤ ਹੈ ਲੇਜ਼ਰ ਸਪੋਟ ਹੈ ਨਾ
ਲੇਜ਼ਰ ਸਪੋਟ ਫੋਟੋ ਫੇਸ਼ੀਅਲ Thermage anti-aging, laser hair removal, laser spa, where beauty meets elegant professionals.
Laser spot, Highway 10 or Queens ke Sangam par. Call Shaila 905-487-2680.
Jadon tuhanu accident ho janda hai, tuhade paas kai tarah de sawal hunde han.
ਕਦੇ ਵੀ ਆਪਣਾ ਕਲੇਮ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ ਸੈਟਲ ਕਰਨ ਦੀ ਕੋਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਨਾ ਕਰੋ
ਆਪਣੇ ਹੱਕਾਂ ਲਈ ਇੱਕ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਤਜਰਬੇਕਾਰ ਪਰਸਨਲ ਇੰਜਰੀ ਲਾਇਰ ਰਮੇਸ਼ ਸੰਗਾ ਨੂੰ ਮਿਲੋ
ਤੁਰੰਤ ਸਾਡੀਆਂ ਸੇਵਾਵਾਂ ਲਈ ਆਓ ਤੇ ਵਧੀਆ ਤੋਂ ਵਧੀਆ ਮੁਆਵਜ਼ਾ ਲਓ
ਹਮ ਰੀਅਲ ਸਟੇਟ ਫੈਮਿਲੀ ਲਾਅ ਔਰ ਇਮੀਗ੍ਰੇਸ਼ਨ ਮੇਂ ਵੀ ਸਰਵਿਸਿਜ਼ ਦੇਤੇ ਹੈ
905-670-9911
अपने कारोबार की तरक्की के लिए प्रिंट पब्लिसिटी और बेहतरीन प्रिंटिंग के लिए सिर्फ एक ही नाम
साइंस टू गो
जहां जदीद टेक्नोलॉजी से स्टोर फ्रंट साइंस चैनल लेटर्स बैनर्स रियल स्टेट साइंस सैंडविच बोर्ड्स व्हीकल ग्राफिक्स बिजनेस कार्ड्स पोस्ट कार्ड्स लेबल्स फ्लायर्स आपके बजट और आपके वक्त में बनाए जाते हैं आपका काम सिर्फ सोचना है क्योंकि
वी प्रिंट योर थॉट्स
साइंस टू गो
खराब लड़की अपनी स्किन की वजह से परेशान हो
तो फिकर की क्या बात है, लेजर स्पॉट है ना।
लेजर स्पॉट, फोटो फेशियल, थर्माज, एंटी एजिंग, लेजर हेयर रिमूवल, लेजर स्पॉट, वेयर ब्यूटी मीट्स एलिगेंट प्रोफेशनल्स।
लेजर स्पॉट, हाईवे 10 और क्वींस के संगम पर। कॉल शैला 905-487-2680।
ਜਦੋਂ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਐਕਸੀਡੈਂਟ ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਹੈ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਪਾਸ ਕਈ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਦੇ ਸਵਾਲ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਹਨ।
ਕਦੇ ਵੀ ਆਪਣਾ ਕਲੇਮ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ ਸੈਟਲ ਕਰਨ ਦੀ ਕੋਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਨਾ ਕਰੋ।
ਆਪਣੇ ਹੱਕਾਂ ਲਈ ਇੱਕ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਤਜਰਬੇਕਾਰ ਪਰਸਨਲ ਇੰਜਰੀ ਲਾਇਰ ਰਮੇਸ਼ ਸੰਗਾ ਨੂੰ ਮਿਲੋ।
ਤੁਰੰਤ ਸਾਡੀਆਂ ਸੇਵਾਵਾਂ ਲਈ ਆਓ ਤੇ ਵਧੀਆ ਤੋਂ ਵਧੀਆ ਮੁਆਵਜ਼ਾ ਲਓ।
ਹਮ ਰੀਅਲ ਸਟੇਟ, ਫੈਮਿਲੀ ਲਾਅ ਔਰ ਇਮੀਗ੍ਰੇਸ਼ਨ ਮੇਂ ਵੀ ਸਰਵਿਸਿਜ਼ ਦੇਤੇ ਹੈਂ। 905-670-9911।
अपने कारोबार की तरक्की के लिए प्रिंट पब्लिसिटी और बेहतरीन प्रिंटिंग के लिए सिर्फ एक ही नाम,
साइंस टू गो।
जहां जदीद टेक्नोलॉजी से स्टोर फ्रंट साइंस, चैनल लेटर्स, बैनर्स, रियल स्टेट साइंस, सैंडविच बोर्ड्स, व्हीकल ग्राफिक्स, बिजनेस कार्ड्स, पोस्ट कार्ड्स, लेबल्स, फ्लायर्स आपके बजट और आपके वक्त में बनाए जाते। आपका काम सिर्फ सोचना है, क्योंकि
वी प्रिंट योर थॉट्स।
साइंस टू गो।
ਮੇਰੇ ਤਾਂ ਇਹ ਵਿਚਾਰ ਨੇ ਕਿ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਦੂਸਰੇ ਮੁਲਕਾਂ ਨਾਲ ਇੱਥੇ ਦੇ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਨਾ ਰੇਟਸ ਬੜੇ ਹਾਈ ਨੇ, ਇਸ ਨੂੰ ਥੋੜ੍ਹਾ ਕੰਮ ਕਰਨਾ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ। ਲੋਕ ਕਾਫੀ ਪਰੇਸ਼ਾਨ ਨੇ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਰੇਟਾਂ ਤੋਂ, ਇਹ ਜ਼ਰੂਰ ਸਰਕਾਰ ਨੂੰ ਘਟਾਉਣੀ ਚਾਹੀਦੀ।
ਆਟੋਮੋਬਾਈਲ ਇੰਸ਼ੋਰੈਂਸ ਇਨ ਆਨਟੇਰੀਓ ਇਜ਼ ਹਾਇਰ ਇਨ ਕੰਪੈਰੀਜ਼ਨ ਟੂ ਅਦਰ ਪ੍ਰੋਵਿੰਸਿਸ, ਸਪੈਸ਼ਲੀ ਮੈਰੀਟਾਈਮਸ ਪ੍ਰੋਵਿੰਸਿਸ। ਆਈਵ ਬੀਨ ਇਨ ਮੈਰੀਟਾਈਮਸ ਫੋਰ ਅਬਾਊਟ 5 ਇਅਰਸ ਨਾਓ, ਐਂਡ ਕੰਪੇਅਰਿੰਗ ਰੇਟਸ ਇਨ ਨਿਊ ਬ੍ਰੰਸਵਿਕ, PEI ਇਨ ਨੋਵਾ ਸਕੋਸ਼ੀਆ ਟੂ ਰੇਟਸ ਇਨ ਆਨਟੇਰੀਓ, ਦੇਰ ਇਜ਼ ਅ ਹਿਊਜ ਡਿਸਪੈਰਿਟੀ। ਆਟੋਮੋਬਾਈਲ ਇੰਸ਼ੋਰੈਂਸ ਡਾਊਨ ਦੇਰ ਕੁਡ ਕਾਸਟ ਯੂ ਐਜ਼ ਲੋ ਐਜ਼ $35 ਪਰ ਮੰਥ, ਵੇਅਰ ਐਜ਼ ਇਨ ਆਨਟੇਰੀਓ ਇਟਸ ਪ੍ਰੀਟੀ ਹਾਈ। ਸੋ ਆਈ ਡੂ ਫਾਈਂਡ ਦੇਰ ਟੂ ਬੀ ਅ ਹਿਊਜ ਡਿਸਪੈਰਿਟੀ, and I wish that someone would rectify the situation.
Insurance rates in Ontario are like really high, like mainly to, you know, young people. They're really biased against young people. I wonder why, but like you have to pay like double the money that someone else is paying just because your age. Like older people pay like gradually low, whereas if you're young, they don't even insure you first of all. Or it's like out of the roof, like $900 a month. That's not even reasonable, right? I would urge the government to take some action against this. This is a major issue that needs to, this is unacceptable, and it's an issue that needs to be taken care of.
Insurance rates da je comparison kariye Ontario de vich zyada hi nahi, bahut zyada ne. Average je apa gal kariye husband wife, ਜੇ ਦੋਨੋਂ ਜੋਬ ਕਰਦੇ ਨੇ, ਦੋਨਾਂ ਦਾ ਕਲੀਨ ਰੈਕਰਡ ਆ, ਤਾਂ 4600 ਦੇ ਕਰੀਬ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਇੰਸ਼ੋਰੈਂਸ ਪੈਂਦੀ ਆ। ਬਹੁਤ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਇਹ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਨਵੇਂ ਬੱਚੇ ਆ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਇੰਸ਼ੋਰੈਂਸ ਆ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਉਹ ਵੀ ਬਹੁਤ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਪੈਂਦੀ ਆ। ਅਤੇ ਕਈ ਵਾਰ ਦੇਖਿਆ ਗਿਆ ਕਿ ਬ੍ਰੈਂਪਟਨ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਬੱਚੇ ਆ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਇੰਸ਼ੋਰੈਂਸ ਡਿਨਾਈ ਕੀ ਕਰ ਦਿੱਤੀ ਜਾਂਦੀ ਹੈ। ਨਵੇਂ ਇਮੀਗ੍ਰੈਂਟਸ ਆਉਂਦੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਇੰਸ਼ੋਰੈਂਸ ਆ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਉਹ ਡਿਨਾਈ ਕਰ ਦਿੱਤੀ ਜਾਂਦੀ ਹੈ। ਜੇ ਆਪਾਂ ਇਹਦਾ ਕੰਪੈਰੀਜ਼ਨ ਕਰੀਏ, ਸਾਡਾ ਗੁਆਂਢੀ ਸਟੇਟ ਹੈਗੀ ਆ ਕਿਊਬੈਕ, ਉੱਥੇ ਵੀ ਇੰਸ਼ੋਰੈਂਸ ਰੇਟਸ ਘੱਟ ਨੇ। ਮੈਨੀਟੋਬਾ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਬਹੁਤ ਘੱਟ ਨੇ। ਅਗਲੇ ਸਾਲ ਤੋਂ ਇੰਸ਼ੋਰੈਂਸ ਰੇਟਸ ਨੇ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਮੈਨੀਟੋਬਾ 'ਚ, ਉਹ ਜੇ ਮੈਂ ਗਲਤ ਨਾ ਹੋਵਾਂ ਤਾਂ 6% ਦੇ ਕਰੀਬ ਘੱਟ ਰਹੇ ਨੇ। ਸਸਕੈਚੁਅਨ 'ਚ ਰੇਟ ਘੱਟ ਨੇ, BC ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਰੇਟ ਘੱਟ ਨੇ। ਹੁਣ ਪ੍ਰੋਬਲਮ ਦੀ ਜੜ ਕਿੱਥੇ ਹੈ? ਜੜ ਇਹ ਆ ਵੀ ਇੱਥੇ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਇੰਸ਼ੋਰੈਂਸ ਆ ਉਹ ਟੋਟਲੀ ਪ੍ਰਾਈਵੇਟ ਸੈਕਟਰ ਦੀ ਹੈਗੀ ਆ। ਕਿਊਬਿਕ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਉਹ ਪਾਰਟਲੀ ਪ੍ਰਾਈਵੇਟ ਆ, ਪਾਰਟਲੀ ਗਵਰਨਮੈਂਟ ਦੀ ਹੈ। ਜਿਹੜੀ ਲਾਈਫ ਕਵਰੇਜ ਆ ਉਹ ਗਵਰਨਮੈਂਟ ਕਰਦੀ ਹੈ, ਜਿਹੜੀ ਪ੍ਰੋਪਰਟੀ ਡੈਮੇਜ ਦੀ ਕਵਰੇਜ ਆ ਉਹ ਪ੍ਰਾਈਵੇਟ ਕੰਪਨੀਜ਼ ਕਰਦੀਆਂ ਨੇ। ਇਸ ਕਰਕੇ ਸਾਰੇ ਪੌੜੇ ਦੀ ਜੜ ਪ੍ਰਾਈਵੇਟਾਈਜੇਸ਼ਨ ਆ। ਜੇ ਗਵਰਨਮੈਂਟ ਆਪਣੇ ਹੱਥ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਲਵੇ, ਪਬਲਿਕ ਨੂੰ ਇਹਦੇ 'ਚੋਂ ਫਾਇਦਾ ਹੋ ਸਕਦਾ।
ਵੈਲ, ਆਟੋਮੋਬਾਈਲ ਇੰਸ਼ੋਰੈਂਸ ਪ੍ਰਾਈਸਿਸ ਆਰ ਗੋਇੰਗ ਜਸਟ ਆਊਟ ਆਫ ਰੀਚ ਫੋਰ ਮੈਨੀ ਮੈਨੀ ਐਵਰੇਜ ਸਿਟੀਜ਼ਨ ਆਫ ਦਿਸ ਕੰਟਰੀ ਬੇਸਿਕਲੀ, ਐਂਡ ਪਰਟੀਕੁਲਰਲੀ it's getting hard to get auto insurance, and when you apply for different places for the auto insurance, it's just not affordable anymore. And then on top of it, certain areas are targeted properly. I don't know, is it being targeted or what is happening? But if you live in Brampton and you give a Brampton address, your insurance is way higher than other areas. So I personally think that the insurance company should look into this, why the whole community and the whole city is being penalized because of some bad apples or bad people or bad claims. The whole Bramptonian area or Peel region or 905 region should not be penalized. So main akhri ji ko gal khanga ki sare sari community nu is area de vich jade rehnde ne sare nu mil ke is cheez de bare petition karni chahidi hai, mil ke appeal karni chahidi hai government nu, insurance companies nu ki jada Peel region particularly Brampton de vich jade sade insurance rates ne ohna de utte dhyan ditta jaye te itthe Brampton area de vich rate kyon zyada ne is cheez te puri tarah investigation kiti jaye.
ਦੇਖੋ ਜੀ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਮੈਂ ਗੁਰਦੀਸ਼ ਮਾਂਗਟ ਹਾਂ ਜੀ ਬ੍ਰੈਂਪਟਨ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਰਹਿਣਾ ਪਿਛਲੇ ਤਕਰੀਬਨ 27-28 ਸਾਲ ਤੋਂ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਇੰਸ਼ੋਰੈਂਸ ਦਾ ਤਾਲੁਕ ਹੈ ਇਹਦੇ ਕਈ ਰੀਜ਼ਨ ਨੇ ਜੇ ਤਾਂ ਦੇਖੋ ਆਪਾਂ ਦੇਖੀਏ ਵੀ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਦੀ ਮਿਨੀਮਮ ਵੇਜ ਕਿੱਥੋਂ ਕਿੱਥੇ ਪਹੁੰਚੀ ਹੈ ਪਿਛਲੇ 25 ਸਾਲਾਂ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਅਤੇ ਇੰਸ਼ੋਰੈਂਸ ਦੇ ਰੇਟ ਕਿੰਨੇ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਵਧੇ ਨੇ ਇਹ ਬਹੁਤ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਵੱਡਾ ਗੈਪ ਹੈ ਬਹੁਤ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਬੋਝ ਪਿਆ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਦੇ ਉੱਤੇ ਅਤੇ ਬਾਕੀ ਇਹਦੇ ਕਾਰਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਪੜਚੋਲ ਕਰਨ ਦੀ ਵੀ ਲੋੜ ਹੈ ਵੀ ਕੀ ਇਹ ਇੰਸ਼ੋਰੈਂਸ ਕੰਪਨੀਆਂ ਲਾਲਚੀ ਹੋਈਆਂ ਨੇ ਕੀ ਉਹ ਮੁਨਾਫਾ ਕਮਾਉਣ ਦੀ ਰੇਸ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਲੱਗੀਆਂ ਹੋਈਆਂ ਨੇ ਅਤੇ ਆਮ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਦਾ ਘਾਣ ਹੋ ਰਿਹਾ ਜਾਂ ਕੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਆਪ ਜ਼ਿੰਮੇਵਾਰ ਹੈ ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਜਦੋਂ ਭਾਈ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਨਵੇਂ ਨਵੇਂ ਆਏ ਸੀ ਮੇਰੇ ਯਾਦ ਹੈ ਅਸੀਂ ਆਹ ਐਕਸੀਡੈਂਟ ਕਲੇਮ ਜਾਂ ਹੋਰ ਜੋ ਸੁਣਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਅੱਜ ਕੱਲ੍ਹ ਜਿੰਨੀ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਐਡਵਰਟਾਈਜ਼ਮੈਂਟ ਸੁਣਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਬੜੇ ਘੱਟ ਸੁਣਦੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਸੀ ਰੋਜ਼ ਖਬਰਾਂ ਪੜ੍ਹਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਕਿੰਨੇ ਫਰਾਡ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਨੇ ਕਿੰਨੇ ਜਾਲੀ ਐਕਸੀਡੈਂਟ ਕਲੇਮ ਫਾਈਲ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਨੇ ਆ ਪਿੱਛੇ ਜਿਹੀ ਟੋਰਾਂਟੋ ਸਟਾਰ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਇੱਕ ਬੜੀ ਵੱਡੀ ਰਿਪੋਰਟ ਦਿੱਤੀ ਸੀ ਵੀ ਕਿਵੇਂ ਫਿਜੀਓਥੈਰੇਪੀਆਂ ਵਾਲੇ ਅਤੇ ਆਟੋ ਗਰਾਜਾਂ ਵਾਲੇ ਜਾਂ ਜੋ ਵੀ ਹੈ ਇੰਸ਼ੋਰੈਂਸ ਫਰਾਡ ਦਾ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਮਾਮਲਾ ਹੈ ਅਤੇ ਕਈ ਇੰਸ਼ੋਰੈਂਸ ਬ੍ਰੋਕਰ ਜਾਣਦੇ ਨੇ ਇਹ ਸੁਣਨ 'ਚ ਆਇਆ ਕਿ ਬ੍ਰੈਂਪਟਨ ਮਿਸੀਸਾਗਾ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਪੀਲ ਦਾ ਏਰੀਆ ਇੱਥੇ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਇੰਸ਼ੋਰੈਂਸ ਲੈਣ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਹੀ ਬੜੀ ਦਿੱਕਤ ਆ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ ਪਰ ਬਹੁਤ ਵੱਡਾ ਬੋਝ ਹੈ ਇਹ ਸਾਡੇ ਉੱਤੇ ਸਰਕਾਰ ਨੂੰ ਕੁਛ ਨਾ ਕੁਛ ਕਰਨਾ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਜੇ ਅਲਬਰਟਾ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਇੰਸ਼ੋਰੈਂਸ $50-$60 ਮਹੀਨੇ ਦੀ ਹੋ ਸਕਦੀ ਹੈ ਅਤੇ ਇੱਥੇ ਸਾਨੂੰ $250-$300 ਉਸੇ ਕਵਰੇਜ ਲਈ ਦੇਣਾ ਪੈਂਦਾ ਮੇਰਾ ਖਿਆਲ ਹੈ ਇੱਕੋ ਹੀ ਮੁਲਕ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਡਬਲ ਕਾਨੂੰਨ ਬੜਾ ਵੱਡਾ ਫਰਕ ਲੱਗਦਾ ਹੈ ਜੀ